How many went to the march? Great, 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 excellent. Were any of you at the caucus, state caucus? Okay, great. Wasn't it great down in Washington this week? It's fantastic. But, you know, and the principle that the devil tries to stop anything is good, he sort of whacked me three times. We had our youth group go down for the pro-life conference, the youth Students for Life, which I'm going to mention, and then we had a bus go down. And I didn't want to go on the bus. I've done the bus. I've been on the bus like 30 times. I've done the bus. I'm too old for the bus. And I wasn't going to go in the van with the youth group because celibacy has its benefits, and one of them is you don't have to drive with teenagers for 8 hours. So my bright idea was to drive down in my own car. So on Monday I got the car aligned. Imagine something I have being out of line. And I got 4 new tires, so I was ready to go, and I drive down there, and when I get to Washington, a tire blows.
Oh my God.
And the tire blows, and it damages the rim, so I have to get a new tire and a new rim. That was the first whack. Then I get a cold, which I still have. And the third whack was that the hotel soap made a rash come out of my face. So there goes the modeling contract I've been working on. Down at the march, as many of you saw, it was just an extraordinary sea of young people. Extraordinary. It was just really extraordinary. And it's been that way for years and years and years. I remember the first March for Life in 1974. I was a college student, about 25,000 people there, most of them were middle age. I was impressed how many students were there then, and that wasn't very many of us. But this was extraordinary, extraordinary. And all the other people received a great lesson in how the news media manipulates the news in the march, because they were all going up Constitution Avenue. I was probably halfway through in the march, and there were already 100,000, 150,000 ahead of us, around the Supreme Court and above us, but you're looking back and you see this enormous crowd of people, and everybody's taking pictures. And the young people are saying, awesome, cool, that's cool. And you can imagine the discussions on Monday at the lunch hour when they go to school and their friend asks them what they did, what it was like. And their friends say, hey, dude, I didn't hear anything about it, man. I don't think like much, there must be many people there, right? And the response was like, dude, look at this picture. You see this? It was awesome. There were hundreds of thousands of people. Well, how come I didn't hear the news? No, you know, I know. We have the young people. The young people are pro-life. We've been very, very effective. We as a pro-life movement have been very, very effective in affecting the young people. And the message is clear. This conference, the Students for Life conference, was extraordinary. It was held at this mega Baptist church, which could fit a number of my parish, my St. Brendan's Inn side. It's an enormous auditorium in Upper Marlboro, Maryland. It was filled with thousands of college and high school students. And just really extraordinary.